Continuing our Miles Morales and Into the Spider-Verse coverage today, we are discussing another spider ability that Miles has that, well, Peter Parker just doesn't have, man. For those of you who didn't watch the first episode, well, first off, shame on you, and second off, the link is in the card above, where I outline the strongest ability that Miles has at his disposal, aka the Venom Strike. For today's video, though, I'm going to review Miles' spider camouflage, or just camouflage. Whenever you discuss a Spider-Man power, it's pretty much impossible to not add spider as a prefix to whatever ability you happen to be discussing. Spider sense, spider reflexes, spider body odor. The possibilities are endless. The spider that bit Miles was not the same spider that created Peter Parker. They are slightly different. Therefore, they grant slightly different powers. When Brian Michael Bendis created Miles, he wanted to differentiate him from Peter Parker in a few different ways, and the way he went about doing that was to give him some additional powers. One of those powers is something that's been teased in the films and is seen in nature with actual real-life spiders: the ability to camouflage yourself. The ability to camouflage yourself is an important trait in the animal kingdom. It prevents smaller animals from being spotted and immediately eaten by larger animals, and it also allows certain predators to mask their appearance in order to get the drop on faster prey. Miles is able to change his appearance, including his clothes, to blend into his surroundings, which leaves him in a state of near invisibility. Only a few enemies of Spider-Man with access to enhanced superhuman traits would even be able to tell that Spider-Man is near with this trait functioning. The ability is kind of weird, though. It makes sense for Miles to be able to turn his actual body different shades of colors to blend into his surroundings, but with the introduction of the fact that he can change his clothes as well, it adds a new level of complexity that might need a little bit of further review and analysis. So let's break out some damn science. You see, technically, the source and scientific explanation for this power is never fully explained, but we live in an age where I have Google, so I've done some research. See, coloration in animals is produced by reflection and scattering of light cells in tissues, and by absorption of light by a chemical pigment within cells of the skin. Cells containing pigments are called chromatophores. Certain types of animals in the animal kingdom can centralize or disperse these cells and their subsequent pigments to, well, change colors. If it sounds like that's something that I got from Google, it's because I did. You're right, I'm an engineer by day, not a biologist, sue me. The changing of chromatophores combined with other types of color-changing cells allow animals to rapidly change colors to blend in with their surroundings. All right, enough science talk, let's get wacky. I believe that much like the Venom Blast, Miles is able to extend his own bioelectrical field around his body to change not only the color of his skin, but also to manipulate the colors of the materials that make up the fabrics that he wears, namely his spider suit. He's essentially able to manipulate his own cells and the cells of the materials that he wears in order to change colors depending upon what he needs to blend into. Similar to most comic book powers, this ability first manifests itself during a time of extreme stress, when Miles is witnessing an argument between his father and his uncle. You can kind of consider this a fight or flight mechanism that Miles does eventually gain control over. And that being said, he can do this with pretty much any clothing. In fact, the first time he does it, he doesn't understand it and he thinks he's evaporating. And this isn't limited to just blending in with a wall or something like that either. If Miles concentrates, he can literally become invisible to the naked eye, just standing in the middle of a room. In fact, Miles could be in your room right now. You have no idea. You better close that browser history. The camouflage ability, in my opinion, is really awesome, and it adds another level of depth to the character that Peter doesn't have. Now, I'm not saying that Peter isn't the OG greatest Spider-Man of all time, but this is actually pretty great, because all things considered, Miles has no formal fight training. Much like Peter in his youth, he's relying solely on his abilities and speed. However, most of Miles' enemies were also Peter's, so they know how Spider-Man moves and what his strengths and weaknesses are. Without these new abilities, it's probably safe to say that Miles would get his ass kicked pretty much immediately. Sometimes it's better to blend in and escape than fight and potentially die. And that is about it for this video, but one burning question we have left in the comments section is this: Predator or Miles Morales? Who wins and why? Let us know down in the comments section. And if you're new to this channel, please like and subscribe and share this with your friends. We are really hyped for Into the Spider-Verse. We actually got to see the first 35 minutes at New York Comic Con this year. And let me tell you, the hype is real, boys. It was incredible. I really enjoyed it. And if Sony keeps going down this path, I have nothing but well wishes for the future of the Sony animated Spider universe. This has been Nick with Key Issues, and you know the motto, comics over everything.